tell you, I've had the pleasure the last week or so, maybe the last couple of weeks, of sitting in on the rehearsals for this show. I can honestly say, in terms of our middle school productions, there was nothing more exciting than seeing what was happening with these students and what you're about to see tonight. I'm very excited for you. I think it's a fantastic show. And with that being said, I'm going to introduce the show's creator and director, Kane Ashton. Woo!
Just two more shameless plugs. First of all, we've got these signed posters from the cast. They're for sale out in the lobby. Those are for 15. There's only a limited number of them, but the whole cast signed it. I'm keeping this one for you. And then there's also these awesome D20 necklaces, which my amazing wife, Jonna Joy Ashton, made. So if you are a D&D player, it's very handy little, you can pop the D20 out and actually use it. They're awesome. Okay, so when I first wrote this script and handed it over to my boss, who you just heard from, he told me I was crazy. And so I cut a few pages out, and it was still too long, and I decided I was gonna do it anyways, which he also said was crazy. And I think that the fact of the matter is he's right, except I had the pleasure of working with a group that isn't like any other group of students I've worked with before. Usually in a middle school production, even if it's a pretty normal show, you kind of have to convince them, or a lot of them, that what you're asking them to do is reasonable, and not too weird and uncool. In this particular production, I came in and I said, so we're gonna do a show about Dungeons and Dragons. And they were like, awesome! Okay. And then some of you also don't get to be fantasy characters because some of you are going to be dying kids. Awesome! Even better! And then also we're going to spend the first 2 weeks playing D&D so that you get a feel for it. Yes! And I'm going to score the whole thing with basically all metal music. Wait, there's not going to be a Green Day song in a CVDAA show? The only complaint that I ran into. So that was a major, that's the only thing that let this show happen, is your kids. And I thank you so much for letting me work with them. They are a great, great group of people. And they really brought their own life to this show. It would not be the same if they had not put all of their love and energy into it. That being said, please enjoy Battles in Bedpans.
Get it.
Yeah, you hit him both times. First one, bam, you plug him in the gut. And
Right, don't you think we should see what's up with that kid?
Lol, no. Kid is definitely faking.
Right, well, this is a hospital. Just saying.
Oh no, he's dead.
Point taken. I think I'm gonna...
I'm not faking it out.
I'm not. I was just really, 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 really out of breath. So, what are you guys doing? Sounds cool.
It's none of your business.
Oh, come on, don't be like that. So bored in here.
Are you a patient? What's your problem?
Yeah, that's personal. Is your name really Gimlor? Because if so, that is literally the coolest name I have ever heard in my life.
No. That's my character's name.
What?
It's her character's name. We're playing Dungeons and Dragons. Her character... Gimlor's name is her character. And she's... She's a warrior.
That's awesome. So, how does it work? Can I play?
No.
Why not?
Because when does not simply walk into Dungeons and Dragons? You are a player character. You're not about the math and the lingo.
Oh, I'm a fast learner.
And furthermore, playing as an all-female adventuring prize was a moot point anyway.
Oh, I can play a girl character. I don't care. Please? I have no friends.
What's wrong?
Garfield, like the cat. But I hate the cat. It's on Mondays. Give me a break. So many people call me Gar instead. Like the pirate sound, Ar, but more Gar.
Gar. Could you give us a moment to talk about this alone, please?
Oh, I know what that means. That means, hey Gar, could you step outside for a sec so we can figure out an excuse not to let you play? Come on, it'll be real cool, I promise.
Fine, you can stand here while I talk about it. Just sit in the corner, plug ears, and come or something.
Awesome.
Damn, that boy can talk.
So, what are you thinking?
I like him, he's funny.
Yeah, but do we really want to teach him all about the game?
What?
Also, like, do you think you guys recognize him?
No.
Should we? He says he's a patient, but I've never seen him before.
Well, it is a pretty big hospital.
True. I don't know. He seems interesting at the very least.
You did say we should have a four-player support.
Yeah, but what if the odds Caleb wants to play a support character?
You're the DM. Yeah, just tell me how to. I mean, we have like a fanboy.
True. This may be a story, Chris. I mean, a young boy that used to be the all-girly and dear boy group with a wheelchair girl, two cans of kids, and a human torch. Get it? Torch.
Yet.
Guys, focus. Is he in or isn't he?
Well, you're called him, Master.
Hey, Gar, we want to talk to you, idiot!
What?
Was that Run to the Hills you were saying?
Hell yeah, it looked like it.
Fine. Maybe you can play with us.
Yes!
I said maybe. For now, you're just gonna have to watch and try to keep up.
Fine. Promise I will prove myself worthy. So, how's it work?
Please, this game is so much more complicated than that. The only way anyone really gets how it works is hours and hours of playtime. For now, let's start with the basics.
Basics. Got it. Listen. Lay it on me.
So, Dungeons and Dragons is a fantasy role-playing game, but I think that's a bit inaccurate because the core of the game, in actuality, is storytelling. We tell a story together. I, as the Dungeon Master, create characters, scenarios, and environments, while you, as the players, decide what you want to do with those things. You can do almost anything your character wants. The only thing standing in your way, and I guess what keeps the game, are the dice. The normal dice set for D&D consists of several different dice, but the one you'll mostly be concerned with is this guy, the 20-sided die, or D20 for anyone in the know. You will roll it for just about everything. Want to climb a tree? Roll an athletics check. Lie to someone? Deception check. Even just to notice things in life, you'll be asked to roll for perception. When this happens, you roll the D20 and add particular bonuses or penalties you may have based on your character. veterans. I will compare that number with the number I have set as a difficulty check, and based on that, you will succeed or fail. For example, Amy, I believe it is your turn.
Right, yeah. I'm gonna hit one with an arrow. Sam would get one just smacked.
Cool. So roll 10.
13.
Cool. So players don't usually know these numbers, but I'll tell it to you just for this example. The difficulty set, or in this case, armor class, hit one of these orcs, is 12. So perfect. She just made it. Now roll for damage.
So that'd be a d8 plus 4. Cool. 10 damage.
I believe that means, yep. Flip your arrow, sails true, and lands right between his eyes. He falls down dead.
Gnarly. Do more.
Well, I take this as a point. Let's keep the battle going, ladies.
All right. I'm a cast fireball. I'm sorry. It's just for some reason, the only thing I can picture is you throwing the little atomic fireball cannons. Great, now that's the only thing I can picture.
Please.
Sounds like a cheap way to avoid making an actual fireball to me, but whatever. This show has no production value anyways.
Ha! We're victorious once again, my friends.
No, really?
What other wise insights do you have in store for us today, Gimlord?
If you don't learn to hold that tongue of yours, Azrath, someone will cut it right out of you.
Friends, be kind. We're at our best when we work in harmony. And if you two brains couldn't tell, we killed our last chance of a good interrogation.
Oh, shut up, you wimpy elf. Where's the fun in keeping them alive? Now, who's up for supper?
It's not about fun, Gimlord. It's about the fact that they might...
I don't care about anything. Your visions? Yeah, the orcs. Okay, so maybe you predicted that, but it's probably just another elven lie.
Hey, I wouldn't be too hasty, Gim. I feel it too. There are dark times on the horizon.
Oh, yeah, and winter is coming, and all that paranoid mumbo-jumbo. Guess what? I haven't felt a thing, and it's still-
The tome of fog has been stolen, Gimlord. If we don't find this guy-
Oh, don't give me that. Every time someone steals a tome, people get all up in arms, but it always ends up being some puny old fanatic who can't even complete the ceremony correctly.
Well, if it isn't the maiden, it's a mayhem!
Who are you?
Don't ask it questions, elf.
I would dwarf, but it can't seem to move.
Well, neither can I, you bloody crazy. Saying elf is a sort of insult.
Doesn't feel good to be other, does it?
Guys, not the time. Hi. Who are you, and how do you know us?
About time. My name is Lord Salazar, and I am here to fulfill my destiny.
Okay, so what's your destiny?
My destiny, fame, glory, dominion, power. Do you seriously not know of me?
We fight a lot of people. Hate to break it to you, honey, but
you're not special.
But it is I, Lord Salazar, the criminal mastermind you've been tailing for days. Come on!
Oh, you're the one who stole the dragon's home.
I know the Of course it's me!
Have you heard tales of my nefarious deeds? My unbridled cruelty? My incomprehensible powers?
Oh, let me guess. These are stories you've been spreading yourself.
No! My arcs are supposed to- Shut up!
A couple freaks like you probably can't get into the cool people's taverns we've been hanging out in anyway. It doesn't matter.
Rise, my Kalanish hench orcs!
What? Mastering my powers? That's not fair!
Your mom's not fair!
Don't have to dare talk about my mother!
Orcs, take him away!
Awesome. Thanks for the revive, boss.
I found the goners for sure.
Yeah, just one question though, boss. If they're so dangerous to your plan, why keep them alive?
Yeah, couldn't we just kill them now and be done with it?
Not that you aren't strong enough to defeat them, but just as insurance, you know? I mean,
but why risk them? I don't know, escaping the cage?
Maybe killing us?
And maybe, just maybe,
turning this whole situation around and defeating you in the process?
Or even accidentally introducing them to a fourth hero. Again, not saying it's likely.
But, I mean, if there's really no use for them now, it might be best just to kill them and leave the genes.
Because I've seen this stuff happen in movies and TV, like, seriously, all the time.
What is this? Movies? TV? Don't talk to me with your stupid orcish words! And don't you dare give me tips on being evil! Take them away! Kill them now! Ha! Then who would I monologue at later about my inevitable victory, fools?
Dude, that was so awesome. They were like, whatcha? And then the Salazar Slytherin lady was like, wahaha. And then you guys were like talking character and stuff, and then you did math, which I didn't understand. But that was so cool.
Yeah, we figured most of the audience won't get all the math and stuff either, so we're kind of glossing over that part. You still want to play with us?
Of course.
Okay, well, you're going to have to create a character. This is the player's handbook. Thanks. It shows all the information you need to get familiar with all the fine rules and structure of the game. Now, normally, you'd be able to play whatever character you want, but
we need a support character.
Like, desperately. Support character?
Yeah, someone who doesn't do much direct damage, but can help the team heal or make the other guys weaker. Stuff like that. Now, you can pick whatever race you want from the races section, which is right here. But as far as a support class, I recommend
I can be a dragon, dude? That's sick!
They're called Dragonborn. They make nice clerics, which would work if you choose domain life. But I'd recommend a bard. They're basically like magical musicians. So you play one kind of song, you help the team heal. Play another, and we get stronger.
Dude, that's the coolest class ever. Do I get to pick my instrument?
Yeah.
Nice. I'm gonna have an electric guitar and power y'all up with the awesomeness of my legendary metal. There's no electricity in D&D.
Yeah, you'll have to be like a lute or something. Now, I don't expect you to be able to make a character all on your own, so give it your best shot tonight and I'll help you out at tomorrow's session.
You guys play every day?
Yeah, what else am I gonna do? I can't go outside with all the germs and stuff.
Is that gonna be a problem for you? No, I'll make it work.
Alright, well, it's almost 5, so get out of here. My parents are gonna be here soon.
It's almost 5?
Yeah, just
crap. I gotta go. See you tomorrow! That dude is strange.
Good taste in music, though.
Doing anything wrong.
But then he keeps pushing and questioning. And then I finally say, no offense, sir, but why you gotta keep grilling me like this? And then he says, no offense, ma'am, but I'm used to girls your age having someone to hang out with on a Friday night. And that's how I got burned. Get it? It's like giving someone the third degree.
Oh my god! Oh.
Wow, please stop.
Oh my god, please stop. You're embarrassing everyone here.
That's great.
So, what really happened to you, though? What really happened to you?
All right, let's get things started. Thought you can just watch your mark on your character sheet. There's not a lot of battle planned today, so I'll be able to answer some of your questions.
No battle? Where's the fun in that?
Actually, I finished last night. I was gonna go with one of the dragon war thingies, but I thought I might be more useful to the group as just a human.
You did the whole character sheet by yourself?
Give me that. Ozia the Awesome?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I figure I'm playing a brutal war musician. Why not give a little nod to the Prince of Darkness? I put the Awesome, though, because, I mean, look at her backstory. She's supposed to be a bit cocky. I figured it'd be the title she'd choose. Well, now I'm thinking I should have gone with something like Ozia, Princess of Darkness.
Damn, that's cool.
How bad did he do?
He didn't mess up.
Seriously? I can't even do that.
Not without a little help, at least.
Well, I told you guys, after I read the handbook, it
really... You read the whole player's handbook?
Yes.
In one night?
I guess I'm a fast reader.
Whoa, are you one of those, like, head trauma-induced geniuses?
I don't sleep much, and, I don't know, I didn't want to be behind, so can I play now?
Alright, I had planned for you to be in this session, but it shouldn't be too hard to work you in. I've got my eye on you, though.
Sweet.
Alright, so, after months of tracking, the thief you were hired by the Keepers of Chaos to find finally reveals herself to you. Lord Salaz is her name. Lord what? Who knows? But she's got her own world domination, and reanimators who totally captured you. Now, the three of you wake up in a small cage. You're weak, you're bruised, and it's pretty dark, so you can't see much. But a little bit is worth it.
Oh, wait, where am I?
I'm getting to that. You can't see much, but a little ways away you make out the shapes of the three orcs who captured you. Between them, you see the unconscious body of a human woman.
Ooh, me, that's me, right? Ozia the Awesome bringing it in with a grand entrance.
God, shut up. You're unconscious.
Right.
I'm so hungry. Could we just, please get on with this?
Maybe if Doug here wasn't being such a fussy little brat.
All I want is a bit of variety now and then. We're always just roasting them to lay over a fire.
Fine, throw some seasoning on it for all I care. I just don't like your stupid little pies.
Quiche. It's called quiche. And they're delicious. Shrug. Don't you want to try a new delectable way to eat human?
Does it take long to make?
Of course it does. All those fancy-pansy.
Fancy-pansy? You're such an orc. You think eating at a table is fancy-pansy? And I'll have you know that Gulia Wild has a recipe that you can make in under an hour. Thank you very much.
Such an orc? Those chips of the city are going to your head, Doug. They've got you turning on your own kind.
You know, we orcs could learn a thing or two from the other races. They know how to cook, and that's for sure.
But isn't that like cultural appropriation or something?
No, it's just tasty food. Food that we're not eating right from body. See the little fingers? All of the things that they kind of live to touch?
Wait, so are they gonna eat her?
What gave you that idea?
Okay, well then, I'm just gonna smash open the gate and let's fight.
Smash with what? You notice that all of your gear is gone. It's lying in a pile over there near the orcs.
Oh dear, they're going to eat her. We have to do something.
Oh, yes. But I've just noticed that all our gear has been
Worry not, friends. I got this.
Ha! Puny elf thinks she can bust through orcish iron.
Not everything in life is about busting, my lord. Need I remind you that my years of becoming one with nature have given me the abilities of shapeshifting. But I'm a little embarrassed to do it while everyone's looking. So if, you could,
And we're the Maidens of Mayhem! this guy. How about we interrogate him while he's still charmed?
Where's Salaza headed, Ort?
To Tyrol, of course. Where the last dragon shrine is said to be held, but you'll never get that out of me.
Fantastic. We done here?
Yeah, let's just loot these orcs and go.
By the way, your friend was right. Quiche is delicious.
Well, welcome to the party, Azzy. We're done.
Yeah, I gotta go do some sort of x-ray for whatever reason.
Oh, you going to imaging? I'll walk you over there.
It's not funny if you set yourself up for it.
Not kosher. Sorry, I was just curious. I've never had friends as cool as you guys before.
I wouldn't say friends. We've hung out twice, but I'll tell you my thing if you tell me yours.
Compared we don't have much time, you know, I could get in big trouble.
Sorry guys, I gotta go. See you tomorrow though.
Redundant. And honestly, I plan to make some major budget cuts too. Well, all leadership positions besides my own.
See, that's why, so if you're in a normal state of mind, I probably wouldn't be someone you want to help out.
But you might find me quite persuasive.
That's why I came to pay you a visit, of course. Truel is the home of the last known shrine of Fowl, and I'm gonna need your help finding it.
Oh, and also, there's a couple idiot heroes I might need you to distract for me.
So, why don't you just be a doll and give me your brain?
There we go. That's a good girl.
Oh, and also, don't forget to tell everyone about my Witcher account at Lord Salaza 1. It used to be just at Lord Salaza, but I forgot the password to that one.
What? Oh, it's probably just your visions. What'd you see?
I think she's possessed the Queen of Tyrol. We don't have much time. We need to stop dilly-dallying on side quests.
Oh, really? Well, you're the one who wanted to save those dire turtles instead of just smashing them.
I don't need your sass, Gimli.
Were you up already?
Yeah, you know, I was just polishing the hammer. You go to sleep. I'll keep guard.
You thinking about it?
I don't want to talk about it.
Oh, your wife.
No. My son. It'd be his birthday today.
Oh, you want a son?
Hey, don't push it.
No. It's okay. What do I care to hide it? His name was Gilgamesh. He was just a wee little one when the war hit. He was being taken care of. And
the drow, they tunneled in from behind, and when us soldiers got back, there was nothing left. I just wish I'd gotten to smell that sweet hair of his.
I thought I had it bad being an orphan, but...
There's nothing to say. The world's a cruel place. You gotta smash him before he gets smashed, I guess.
And hey, you're an orphan too?
Yeah. Parents got the death sentence for stealing food to try and feed me. Go figure.
Dad got the plague. Mom was immune because she's an elf, but she just wasn't the same after that. She started sitting there and staring into the distance. It's why I had to learn to fend for myself. And eventually, she just faded back into nature.
Meaning, she's a tree. Her mom got so sad. She turned into a tree. Isn't that hilarious?
Thanks for the love, demon.
Hey, half demon. I had a mom too, you know.
Oh, what happened to her?
I did.
What's that supposed to mean?
Well, she got saddled with me while living in a theocratic city-state. Go figure, right? She kept me good and hidden for a while. The horns were smaller back then, so it was pretty easy. But, I got mad at her one day, because she wouldn't let me go play with the kids in the market. So I ran off to go join them. I jumped right into their jump rope game. But my hood fell off. Bam! She was executed for relations with an abyssal being, and I was whipped for the next 15-ish years as an example to the other citizens. I never really got the example part either. I mean, it's not like either of us asked for this. I didn't ask to be born. And my parents, they weren't exactly a mutual agreement, if you get my drift. I mean, if a demon comes in your house, just go along with it.
Wow. Why do we all have such messed up lives?
Because we live in a messed up world.
But hey, I guess normal people don't end up being famous adventurers. So I guess we're lucky in some twisted backwards kind of way.
Wow, that was deep.
This is why I hate calling a game. There's nothing really to win. I mean, battle, sure, but that's still not winning. Just sort of do it. I guess you win experience, you can get stronger.
It's like life, man. Nothing to win but experience.
That was actually an amazing analogy.
You guys are nerds.
You're a nerd.
You're a nerd. You want to do this? Let's go. DM, I'd like to roll the punch as a wrap in the face, please. Let's go. You want to go? I rolled a hit on you in the face. Let's do this.
I'm going to crush
you. You want to go? I know. It's my favorite. We're not. No.
I believe you left off with all these sites said were true, yes?
the high seas. We'll be caught up with Salaza in no time.
Yeah, sure about that? For all we know, she could be halfway to Whiterun by now.
Nah, she's got a rise into rule. We'll get her.
All of a sudden, from deep within the water, blah!
What's that thing?
Oh, yes, I'm thinking for a good fight.
The sky looks tough. Ozia, rock on!
Uh-oh. It latches onto Ozia and begins sucking her brain. No longer from music. She takes 55 damage.
What? I didn't even try to attack it. Why didn't it go for Gimlorg or something?
No. Maybe it hates music. I don't know. Stuff happens.
We have to do something.
Oh, that looks gnarly.
Eat stone.
Did it phase it?
I mean, it phased him, but he's pretty in town sucking your brain, I guess.
Help!
It's your turn. Okay, I think I'm gonna try and escape. That's 16 plus 4. That's 24 athletics.
You fail. My player keeps sucking.
How do I fail? I had a 20 that's basically a crit.
No, rolling a nat 20 is a crit. 20 with the modifier is still not enough to escape its grasp.
That's not fair.
There's a chance. Chance ain't fair. Ooh, and that's another 4 damage to Ozzy the Awesome.
Down to 8 health and 2 attacks. What the hell is this thing?
Eat fireball, Davy Jones.
No, it's not.
Much towards the maintenance.
Also can't be mind controlled.
Get off my friend!
It doesn't pinch, but not of summit. I guess that means, ooh, oh no. That 70 damage to Ozzy the Awesome, who falls down dead as the mind player, which hunger satisfied, dives back into the ocean.
Ozzy, no!
Come back and fight me, you coward! Evade healer, come on!
Ozzy, please, no!
Quit talking to her healer!
She brought music back to my life again. I'm gonna cut your evolution to be pieces and put my flavor. Come on! This must be some kind of game!
Why aren't you helping her?
Because she can't.
Why not? Because if I'm that far below zero health, there's nothing she can do. I'm dead. Well, Ozzy is dead.
Yep.
So wait, you just in a mood or something? What's going on here?
You didn't roll well. It happens. Now you're dead.
But you choose the monsters and the attack, so I can't help but think that this was a little bit pointed.
Of course you would.
And what's that supposed to mean?
What? You think lives just don't give you what you want? It's chaos. Roll the dice. You can't roll high enough. It happens. Now you're dead.
Rory, is there something?
Shh, I'm talking to Gar right now, Amy.
Okay, now I'm definitely getting the feeling that this was intentional.
No, you'll get it, do you? Sometimes it's just how life is. Sometimes it doesn't matter who you are, how much money you have, or how many people love you. Sometimes the dice just screw you. And sometimes the dice just screw you over and over and over again. But you know what? Just because you roll a couple of ones doesn't mean you should stop playing the game, does it? No! Stick around for the next draw because who knows? Maybe it'll be something good. Maybe you'll see one more thing that makes you happy before you go. But you don't just stop playing!
Oh.
Oh, yeah, oh, you lied a little. Too much we've seen between the three of us, how much we've gone through, but did any of us try to kill ourselves?
Wow.
No.
Maybe roar.
No, don't roar at you. Did you even think about your parents? Did you even realize how much they love you? Because I didn't. At least not until freaking Time Bomb came along and gave me an expiration date.
Oh.
But you won't have to do something yet, would you? So it'd be easy for you to slip away into nothing and never.
I'm depressed.
Yeah, you and every other normal teenager. I'd love to be all angsty and depressed right now, but guess what? I'm choosing dying.
Okay, we're starting to sound like a very angry John Green novel, so why don't we all just take
it?
You don't think I know that you've got it worse? You don't think I get that very logically? My life is pretty freaking dandy. Really, because if so, you don't know one thing about how this feels. It doesn't make any sense, Rory. It just happens, just like the dice. It makes you feel like a crazy freaking monster because your brain just decides to sabotage everything that you've... Rory. Oh my God!
Rory, Liz, okay? Run! Go get the doctor!
Can you hear me?
Go get that Rory!
Rory, go get the pillow!
What's going on?
Rory,
okay!
Thank you.
guess it's a little dorky, but once you get into it, oh my god, it's so much fun.
You're like in this whole other world where you can be whoever or whatever you want to be.
It's not really a game, man. I don't know how to say this in a non-douchey way, but it's more of an experience. I can't describe it.
It's collaborative storytelling.
Okay, and how did this group get started?
No idea. I just found it one day when I was sneaking out of the psych wing.
Well, I was the first one to join. Roy did sort of a watered-down version of it to help me pass the time during chemo.
But then they met me and Vanessa in the cafeteria, and we all like nerd stuff and good music, so it just kind of became a regular thing.
I never really thought I'd get into it, but Roy's just so good at telling stories, I just got hooked.
I never really had enough friends before to play, and I guess the universe wanted me to get a chance before. Nah, that's garbage. The universe doesn't have wants. I got lucky. I got lucky in the chaos.
And you think this is a healthy thing for you?
Well, it keeps my mind off my mom, that's for sure. Plus, I get to be a dork that just likes to smash stuff. No, you're right. Sitting in front of a TV like all the other plebes in here is way better for my acting, improv, math, and social skills of other people of a like mind. Where'd you get that degree from again?
Well, I play this thing called a tiefling. I know it sounds stupid. They're basically demon people, not important. But they have a natural resistance to fire. Plus, my class is a sorcerer specializing in pyromancy. I know it seems trivial or whatever, but getting to be someone different, not only that, but someone who can control the thing that hurt me, there's power in that. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? Because all of this, your therapist ain't got nothing on this game. Especially in the hands of Rory Crane. By the way, have you talked to her yet? Does she really hate me?
Is it healthy? Let me see. Well, there's a young dying girl who wanted to become a fantasy writer, but she's never gonna get to do that because there's a ticking brain tumor in her head. But at the very least, she'll die knowing that four people loved her stories. So, yeah. Not to play the cancer or dying card or anything, but it helps.
But it has incredibly violent themes. Murder, blood, revenge, dead family, scary monsters, and the like.
Yeah, it's freaking awesome. What's your point?
All common themes in real life, too.
Except for the monsters.
Unless you count some people.
Are you, like, being serious right now? Look, I know I'm not supposed to say this, but what's so bad about acting out these violent themes anyways? Shouldn't it say something about our maturity as both individuals and a society that we're able to make ways of acting upon our baser, less favorable fantasies, in a fun, safe environment?
But there is this incident the other day during one of your games, was there not? And there's been a young man escaping from his treatment.
There's a difference between correlation and causation. Look it up.
Escaping from his what? You mean locking him up with a bunch of other sad, depressed, suicidal kids. Not to toot our own horns there, but I'm pretty sure we're doing better for him than you ever have.
Normal adults fight all the time, but the second it happens with a group of kids doing something you adults don't understand... All I have to say is that I'm very sorry for whatever part I played in. I didn't mean to hurt her feelings, it's just she shouldn't have looked up my personal information. But she didn't say anything I didn't need to hear.
It was just a seizure. They're going to be happening more and more as I get closer, so...
But maybe this game is putting too much stress into you.
There's far more love in that room than hate, okay? I was the one who freaked out. I was a jerk. I don't understand what happened. I understand that mental illness is just as much of an illness. Huh. If you look at one way, I've got mental illness too. It's just... We're a loving group. And sometimes we get a little intense with people we, like. A lot.
What about this game's apparent connection to the cult?
Okay, I'm out!
No response.
Well, sir, I guess I'm just trying to figure out how a man of science like yourself is sitting there asking about the occult as if it posed a legitimate threat to his patients.
Look, Garfield, you're a smart kid. You test a 98 percentile on computers. You also repeatedly violate rules of self-assessment. Are nothing but bad things for a therapist. Fair to socialize with others. Enabling to conduct daily activities. Testament safe for your peers.
Yeah, well, there's a lot of idiots out there, so
Look, I didn't ask for that stupid test, okay? I was 8 years old. I clearly had issues already. Then my parents got me psychoanalyzed, and then boom. There's the stupid 98 number hovering over every single thing I do. They're gonna do great things. Get a smart people job, be a doctor or something. There's no excuse not to get A's with a brain like yours. But no offense, being a doctor sounds boring as hell. And I freaking hate school, so what if I'm supposed to use that so-called genius to become the next Slash or something? I don't know. All I'm trying to say is that I don't want to be 98, okay? I want to be normal. And these kids make me feel normal.
Complete disregard for rules. I can't believe you think straight lane method
is just making him happy.
Special things we think are making us happy are to make us feel...
Oh, get off your high horse. We're so good at bad rules anyway. They're only good if they're helping people. And in this case, I can't see any reason not to let them do what they're doing.
So I'm deferring to your judgment on the matter.
Of course, my little girl's running an underground D&D campaign.
She's such a little storyteller.
Yes, well, the real question is whether or not you allow her extra visitation time as Garfield kid.
I see no reason why not to.
Well, he's a bit rowdy. Plus, maybe the people in our group are going to be discharged soon, so there's a lot of germs spreading.
Germs? She has a brain tumor, and we're fretting about germs?
But your immune system...
But what I think my husband is trying to say is that we just want her to be happy these last few months.
If it makes her happy, that's all we care about.
It's been more guys, not disguise, than crazy.
Provide me with parentage, provide me with this one gift, a gift of revival for a fallen ally, an ally sworn to the holy music of the abyss.
What happened?
A good lot of nothing is what it looks like.
No, I had contact. No, there's got to be something.
Best player from Demon Lord Trigon for a girl named Azerath.
That's neat, but I asked for a revive. What's this?
Test case for a flicking ally. We'll provide four as using an upgrade. Use this wisely. I can help you once. Love, Dad.
Charming.
This is the one?
Yep. Oh my gosh! I'm so happy to see you!
Oh, I'm so happy too. Welcome back.
I guess my dad really is a deadbeat dad. Get it? Deadbeat? Because he beat death?
hell itself. Use it wisely.
Dude, this is the meddlest thing that has ever happened. I will, of course, use it wisely.
Well, well, well.
Looks like you clods are doing a bit better than expected.
Oh, come on. I haven't even gotten to try out my new toy.
Unbind us, you cretin.
Yeah, fight us like a real woman.
Unbind you so I can fight you like a real woman?
Let me ask you that, this. If I were to do that, would you not use spells on me?
Of course we use spells on you.
Right, and I'm using a spell on you right now. So basically, I'm playing by your rules. Not my fault, my spells are way cooler and more powerful than yours.
And your game stupid ass is what?
What?
Fools! You face certain annihilation and you make jokes?
You know, my orc said if I ever had a chance to dispose of you, I should take it as soon as possible. Those insolent clods underestimate my true power, or overestimate your true lack thereof.
It doesn't really matter which. Once I awaken the mighty thou, before you will be the first to be enslaved.
Did you just say thou?
Yes.
You sure you didn't mean fog?
No, Thaug! Thaug the great and powerful, feared purple dragon of end times!
I'm pretty sure it's pronounced fog.
Yeah, F-O-G, fog, like the stuff that hangs around in the morning time.
No, Thaug! F-A-U-G. So I guess it sounds like fog, but it has a nice ow sound. It's all fancy and chilly.
Yeah, to me it just sounds like you can't pronounce pub properly.
So, your house, is it made of wooden logs?
Hey guys, I just got a new pet recently.
Oh really? What'd you get?
A dow.
She has ensnared the mind of my queen, Queen Guadavir of Tyrul, who I've sworn an oath to protect.
Ah, so you seek vengeance for the sanity of your queen?
Yes and no. See, my brother, he was a member of her high guard like me. He, spoke out against her before he realized she was under a curse, and she had him executed. My only brother, only living flesh and blood to me, the honor of Tyrul. And I've sworn an oath to protect Rohan with my life.
This chick swears a lot of oaths. Well, Lady Brianna Tyrul, I think we can both prove equal to each other, for we are the Maidens of Mayhem!
Okay.
We believe that we can help you just as you can help us. Though we have sworn no oaths, our paths are crossed in order that we may form an alliance in destroying the evil Lord Salaza. We believe that you're an ensnared queen, Lady Stewart.
But if no oath has been sworn upon it, how do I know I can trust you?
We are bound.
Bound?
Bound. By oath.
Oath.
To slay Lord Salaza.
Yeah.
I suppose that's fair, but to whom are you sworn?
What? What do you mean?
I mean, you can't just swear oaths to the air. Who are you sworn to?
No! Oh, we swear this all to you, old Lady Brianna of Tyrul!
Yep,
I swear!
Yep, swear.
So.
my sword always be in your favor. Unless it conflicts with another oath, of course. So that's basically as long as you don't cross my queen. Or my brother, but he's dead, so you shouldn't have to worry about that. Or my godson. I haven't seen him in a while. I sure have a letter. Oh, and the postman, of course. And the boy with the ocarina. And once, as a result of too many flagons of ale, I was forced to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. And I think that about covers it. Come, my friends, let us ride to us.
Where? To where? Come on, where are we going? Where?
Oh, we're going to...
No, don't tell me. Why would you tell me? I can remember it myself.
It's okay.
No, it's not. I'm the dungeon master. I'm supposed to know where we're... Where are we going?
It's okay, it's okay. Take your time. It's okay, Rory. We're here for you. Don't worry.
At dawn's first light.
Yes, yes, yes.
Tell it a couple more times. See if it gets interesting again.
Just because you want it doesn't mean they have.
Wait, I seem to be missing something. How did that stop you from being an adventurer?
I took an arrow to the knee, young lady.
I'm 212.
You seem to be walking fine.
Yes, seem being the operative word.
I took 12 arrows to the stomach under a week ago.
Give it a rest, Warren. These women know exactly what they're talking about.
I've been resting it for 20 years.
Men, am I right? They get one little arrow and it's an eternity of, ow, my leg, and Wilma, can you get the water? My leg is just not doing well. Meanwhile, we are about to push
That is really interesting. But have you seen your fairy queen Guinevere around? We need to speak to her.
You're no fun.
Are you sure you wouldn't rather sell us that pretty little instrument of yours?
No thanks.
Warren, what have I told you? Don't try magic. You just want to embarrass yourself.
Oh, if it wasn't for my knee being such a boy, I can outcast the best of them.
Sure you could, hon. Now, who shall I tell my queen is calling upon her?
The Maidens of Mayhem!
Woo! Check that out! We didn't need to do an awkward prompt that time!
Our band against our true leader. We put them out west. Also, have you seen Lord Zal's the Witcher account? They posted the funniest things.
Did I hear that the Maidens of Mayhem have arrived?
Yes, my queen. I thought we could discuss some things, like maybe how—
Silence!
Hey! Don't you dare talk to her that way!
I am ruler of this dominion. You shall show me respect. You shall all show me respect. You have offended Supreme Lord Salaza. She is most upset with you. She calls you clods and meanie heads and wishes you could just leave her alone.
Leave her alone.
However, she has asked me to grant you a gift. The gift of her life story, so you know well the legend and legacy of the powerful ruler who will enslave you once Fog is released.
It's pronounced Fog!
It is you who are the idiots.
It's totally pronounced Fog.
Totally.
Fog, the great and powerful, is he who shall return prosperity to these lands, is he who shall restore peace and order to the kingdoms, and make sure everyone has food, love, and a palace all their own. Everyone gets a palace under Lord Salaza's rule.
How will you pay for a palace for everyone, you ask?
Easy. The Shire will pay for it. Those hobbits have been freeloading for years. Especially those sack-filled Bagginses.
Get to the sack-filled Bagginses.
And now, we present to you the Chronicle of Lord Salaza, a legend in 20 parts. Lord Salaza was born 26 years, 5 months, 8 days, 19 minutes, and 10, 11, 12, 13.
Roughly that many seconds ago. Next thing she did was take her first breath. After that, she immediately knew that this world would someday be hers.
Next, she began to cry because that is what babies do. We do not know what the first official cry of Lord Salaza sounded like, but we assume it went something like this.
On my head.
My queen, I have something important. You may speak, but first let me remind you of how amazing Lord Salaza's witcher feat is. How she keeps it witty and under 140 characters. I do not know.
Alright, but what about this? Shouldn't an epic tale such as that be accompanied by some awesome theme music?
Oh, of course. You know, back in my day.
Back in your day, you was just as bad a bagpipe as you are right now. You don't want to hear it.
Yes, both are true. His sucking at bagpipes and the need for such an epic tale to have an equally amazing soundtrack. What a conundrum.
Well, my fair queen, you perhaps release me. I'm sure I could provide you with one. I am a famous musician after all.
It is done. Wow me.
Wow. All right. Y'all ready for this?
Thank you for coming. These visits always make us feel better. Just take it easy at home. If there's anything you need, I'm here. Cheese. Bell. See you soon.
Yeah, cozy.
I'm in remission, so that's good. You always did used to say that I'd be the one to. Oh my God, Rory, this is just so unfair. I just.
Stop crying, you big baby.
What?
I said, stop crying, you big baby. You've got work to do.
You sure you can handle that?
Yeah, aren't we like supposed to take it easy on you?
Don't tell me what I can and can't do, you stupid dwarf. Let's do this thing.
Stop right there, Salaza! Your time is up!
May your weapon strike true and may the dice roll ever in our favor.
Dice? Master? Master, what is dice? They seem to have some sort of new weapon. I'm scared. And where's Guy? Please don't make us fight them.
You mustn't interrupt. Now I gotta start all over with this stupid spell, and I got this stupid move distracting me. Can't you do it? Just do what you're supposed to do and kill.
But where's Gug? We can't fight without him.
Gug, get in here.
Thank you.
insolent little sorcerer. Do you really think I don't know how to pronounce my own name?
No, okay, I get that. But could you just pretend for a moment that your name is Foul? So
we told you.
Oh, man, I'd be so embarrassed if I were you right now.
Oh my gosh, can you please be cool for my friends for like 2 seconds?
You always let your underlings mock you like this.
No, they're not my underlings!
Look,
Foul,
come on, buddy!
I feel like we're going off a wrong start here. See, I awakened you so you can help me take over the world. Sound good?
Or I could just rule the world myself.
Okay, but it's Lord Zalaza, Priestess of Dragons.
Priestess of Dragons, do you have any spells that could control me?
Well,
because I don't feel very controlled. Years of torture and darkness ain't gonna make it sound. Oh, and don't you four try to stop me, or you'll meet the same fate.
Well, that didn't go according to plan. Really? Because for a second there, I thought we wanted 1,000 years of darkness and torture.
But that's not actually going to happen. We're going to go after him, right?
Does it look like we take orders from dragons? Of course we are. We're
the Maidens of Mayhem!
The Maidens of Mayhem!
Awesome. There's a dragon to fight now.
Lots more sections.
Yeah, we'll make sure to keep coming.
Yeah,
we'll be
good.
Oh, shoot. My dad just texted me. Anyone need a ride?
Yeah, that'd be great.
Yeah. Gar, what about you?
No, it's just running a little bit late. I'm gonna stay here for a few minutes.
Okay, see you guys later.
See ya.
Bye.
You guys kind of dropped the ball there, didn't you?
I guess so. We probably should have started trying to hit her earlier. The orcs were a distraction, huh?
A DM never reveals her secrets.
Oh, shut up, nerd.
I'm sorry I yelled at you.
Nope, I probably needed it.
Yeah, but no, I was a bit insensitive.
A bit, but sometimes sensitivity isn't the best choice, you know? Actually, I guess I wanted you to know before, you know, I wanted you to know that you pretty much saved my life.
Ha! Give me the rest! Just because I'm dying doesn't mean you need to patronize me.
No, seriously. I have spent so much of my life comparing myself to anything and anyone I possibly could. Good enough, cool enough, smart enough, successful enough, interesting enough, attractive enough. It's ridiculous, and it's what makes people crazy and depressed is always trying to be better than other people. To win something, but what? You guys were right. The only thing you can really win in life is experience.
You're dark.
Yeah, I know. Just let me finish. See, depression is a way of making you feel like this is it. It hurts right now, and it's gonna hurt like this forever, but you? For you, this really is it, and yet you're still always searching for another good story or to tell another good story. I freaking love that. And I'm not trying to say you cured me or anything. I'm just saying you showed me a better way to look at it.
Come here.
What?
Come here.
Okay.
Closer.
I can't.
Closer.
I can't.
Lean down, numbnuts.
Oh,
First kiss. That's something off the bucket list.
And I miss you too, where I could.
Now get out of here. I'll see you next week.
You're the pillow.
God.
Next week. Yeah. Next week.
Yeah! but since we're running out of time, I'm just gonna trust that they know I love them and thank you very much, and let's get to the raffle. Okay, now. First person to get out here. All right, Charlie, wait.
Yeah!
Okay. 900270.
Round of applause. 90, and half of that is 45.
Half of Smith Lover, it goes to me.
Thank you so much.
Flip the space really quick, and
we're
I'm
fine.
Sorry to.
We're oh. fine. I spoke to the custodians. Oh. We're good.
Okay, awesome. Okay, then let me give a couple of my thank yous. Thank you to Lena Langer and JC Woodfriend. Thank you to all of the crew. That's who's on this side? Ash Castro. Ridiculously ambitious. Also, thank you to my D&D party who came today. Okay, she did all the costumes, which are also wonderful. Yeah. All right. Thank you all very much for having me.